Hey traders, Raghee here, and I'm coming to you right now about 30 minutes after the API, the American Petroleum release on oil. Now let's talk about this because there's an interesting transition we're going to see from the API, this is the private inventory number, to the EIA number that's going to be released tomorrow, every Wednesday, unless there's a bank holiday of some sort, at 10:30 Eastern. So this is about, again, like I said, about 35 minutes ago. And the API is really indicating what we all know. No surprise here. There is another large crude oil inventory build of 13.2 million barrels. And this is backwards looking data taking us to April 17. In other words, the demand is not there and the production and the builds continue to happen week after week as we have these stay-at-home orders in the U.S. So ultimately, the inventory build was slightly smaller than expected. So 13.2 is a huge number, but the overall build was slightly less than expected because the expectations were for just over 15 million barrels. All right, so this is what crude looks like on the 1 minute chart, and you'll see the reaction right here. Why would crude go higher in a 13.2 million barrel release? Because the expectation was 15. So let's talk about expectations for a minute and perspective. Actually, let's do perspective. This is crude oil since 2 p.m. to 5 o'clock. So this is a 3 hour block of 1 minute crude oil trading on my screen right now that you're looking at. You look at the API number, which is right there, and it's hardly noticeable within the overall movement of the ranges that we saw today. I mean, this is it. That's that reaction. So be very cautious about looking at this, because this looks like earth-shattering, doesn't it? But make sure you get very comfortable zooming in and zooming out of your screen, because it gives you a tremendous amount of perspective when you look at a larger range and go, oh, right, that was the move, right, as opposed to this. Sorry, as opposed to that same candle. All right, so let's talk about expectations. We talked about perspective. This is not a huge move. And why was it up? Because again, think if you were expecting 15.1 billion buildup and you got 13.2, it is a little bit less, crude goes up a little bit. Now let's head on over to the Forex Factory calendar. So this is the Forex Factory calendar. And we're going to jump on over to a view of the week. Now, I like this calendar for not just Forex, but also for futures, because it's a global economic calendar. So scroll on down to Wednesday, and we see that crude oil inventories comes out on Wednesday at 10:30 Eastern, and the expectations are for 14.7 million. Now, this is something that I've done throughout my career, and that is I don't really pay any attention to the consensus number from the EIA. Because at 4:31 p.m. on Tuesday, we have a new number. And what does that mean? We have the API number that says, yeah, 14.7, thanks, but no thanks. We have a number now, and it's 13.2. That's what this number is going to be compared against, 13.2, not 14.7. Okay, so keep that in mind. Replace the consensus for EIA with the result from the API. That's why oftentimes the result of the EIA, the number that's going to come out tomorrow at 10:30, seems to be so unusual, because it's not being bounced against this consensus number here of 14.7. It's what we got at 4:30 on Tuesday afternoon. And again, this 13.2 was actually a little bit positive because we expected 15.1. And you saw the reaction is in line with what we're saying, because crude did what? It moved up a little bit on that data. And that's that tiny little candle right there. We moved up a little bit, and quickly we took that back. We've quickly taken that back. So a lot of folks are asking me, what does the current movement in crude mean for crude oil trades? Gang, we've been short crude since mid-February. And I'll show you where. And then we've been short again crude since mid-March, because you'll see the technicals and our trend, not only our overall macroeconomic cycle, but our market trend has been indicating short, short, and stay short. We don't try to step in and buy lows as if crude could go no lower. That's what happened to people yesterday in the May contract. Believe me, June is probably not going to fare much better? Because are we going to see within the span of a month, suddenly places for crude to get stored, suddenly an increase in demand? Keep an eye on a few markers. I'm going to talk about how I use traffic in the premium video to understand if we are really seeing any growing demand in crude. Okay, so this is the way the API to EIA works. I hope this helps, and I'll see you in the next update.